डियर स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू द सेकंड एपिसोड ऑफ सोशल स्टडीज क्लास. दिस इज निशा आजेश. अस यू ऑल वी ऑल हैव स्टडीड द फर्स्ट चैप्टर, स्टार्टेड द फर्स्ट चैप्टर. नाउ वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू द फर्स्ट चैप्टर. सो लेट मी जस्ट रिवाइज व्हाट वी हैव लर्नड इन द लास्ट क्लास. द फर्स्ट चैप्टर्स नेम वाज, as you I think you all remember the name of the first chapter. The name of the first chapter is Our Earth, Continent and Oceans. Okay, the name of the first chapter is Our Earth, Continent and the Oceans. Okay, so what is the definition of continent? Continent is the big landmass on the surface of the earth that is surrounded by water on all sides. What is continent? Continent is a big landmass on the surface of the earth surrounded by water on all sides. Okay, so now how many continents do we have? We have 7 continents. Among the 7 continents, we have started the first continent. What is the first continent's name? The first continent is Asia. Asia is the first continent and Asia is the largest continent. Okay, so in the planet Earth, to 1/3 of the earth is Asian continent. Okay, Asia is the largest continent and Asia is in the Asian continent. Our India is also part of Asian continent. India and its surrounding neighboring countries together forms a subcontinent. Okay, that is what we have learned in the last class. Now we are going to continue with the other 6 continents. Okay, what is the second largest continent? The second largest continent is Africa. Okay, let us have a look in your globe. And the first, before that, let us go to your textbook. Here you can see the flattened size of a globe. This is the flattened size of a globe. In this globe, in this flattened size of globe, here you can see this is the Asian continent and nearby that the second largest continent, Africa is the second largest continent. So here is Asia and here is the Africa. Okay, now let's have a look in your globe. Okay, this is the Asian continent. Okay, let's go to the African continent now. Okay, let's turn, just turn the globe and here you can see this is the African continent. Okay, so here is the Asian continent. Okay, when you turn the globe here you can see the African continent. Okay, so what is the features of the African continent? African continent is the second largest continent and this African continent is surrounded by water on all sides. When you came to the Asian continent was surrounded by water in 3 sides. And the one side was a variety of landforms that were there. But in the Asian continent, when you look into the here, you can understand, African continent, you can understand that the four sides are surrounded by the water. Okay, so let's see what are this African continent. The north side of the African continent. Here, this is the north side of African continent. You can see that the Mediterranean Sea in the north side and the south side. You can see in your textbook, Southern Ocean in the south part and then in the east part, there is Indian Ocean in the east part and the west side, Atlantic Ocean. So, the African continent is surrounded by water on all the 4 sides and the north side is Mediterranean Sea, south side Southern Ocean and the east side Indian Ocean and the west side Atlantic Ocean. As students, you should not, you never forget the physical boundaries of every continent. You must memorize them. That may help you. Okay. Now, what are the specialities of the African continent. We have studied some of the specialties of Asian continent, such as each and every continent has its own specialities. Let's see what is the specialties of the Asian continent, African continent. Okay, in African continent, the first speciality, it is the second largest continent in the world. Okay, the second largest continent is African continent. Okay, and there are some of the specialities there. Have you ever heard about the River Nile, the longest river in the world? River Nile is the longest river in the world. So the Nile River, which is the longest river, is in African continent. Okay, longest river Nile is flowing in through the African continent. Okay, let's write here, longest river Nile flows. Okay, so what makes the African continent special? The longest river in the world, that is Nile River. The Nile River flows through African continent. Okay. The another speciality of African continent is, have you heard about Sahara Desert? Okay. We have in India, we have Thar Desert in India. But the largest desert in the world, the largest desert in the world, you might have studied in GK and even in SST too. The largest desert in the world is Sahara Desert. And the Sahara Desert is also in African continent. So largest desert, Sahara. Largest desert, Sahara, is also in African continent. Okay, the third speciality of the African continent is, even if you take a flattened map of a globe, you can understand that I said this is African continent, and in between, look into the map, in between the Asian continent and the African continent, there is a small gap. Okay, there is a small gap is visible here. So this small gap is known as the Suez Canal. Suez Canal. Okay, so what is the speciality of the Suez Canal? Suez Canal is actually a man-made canal. Okay, so what is Suez Canal? Suez Canal is a man-made canal. Okay. So the speciality of the Suez Canal is the Suez Canal makes a two-way transport in between the Asia and the African. Okay, so through this canal we can have a trade in between Asian and African continents. So without touching Europe, journey is possible between Asia and the Africa. Okay. See, when you don't need to go anywhere, you can find out from your textbook itself. So in between Asia and Africa, there is a small gap is visible here in a blue color. So this is a Suez Canal. It's a man-made canal, and from there, with the trade and transport is possible. So it makes a two-way transport in between two continents. Okay, that is the speciality of the African continent. Okay, the first speciality of an African continent is it is the second largest continent in the world, and the longest river Nile, the world's longest river Nile, flows through it. And the third speciality of the African continent is the largest desert Sahara is in African continent. And the fourth speciality of the African continent is Suez Canal, which is man-made canal, which make transportation easier in between two continents, is in the African continent. Okay, I hope you understood about the African continent. Okay, let's see what is the next continent. What is the next continent's name? Okay, let's see in your textbook. Okay, this is Asia, This is Africa. So next, which is the bigger one? Now North America. North America is the third largest continent. Okay, let's write here. North America is the third largest continent. NORTH. North America. AMERICA. North America is the third largest. Third largest continent. Okay. Third largest continent is the North America. Okay, let's see North America. Let's find out North America in our globe. Where is North America? Okay. We have turn the globe here and you have to come little more here. Okay, North America is here. Okay, here is the North American continent in your globe. Okay, North America, Christopher Columbus and Italian explorer. What is the meaning? Explorer means the one who travels and wanders to find out new things. Okay, that is explorer. So Christopher Columbus, an Italian explorer, discovered North America. Okay, so this North America is in the northern hemisphere. Do you understood the word hemisphere? Northern hemisphere and southern hemisphere. Okay, in the globe. Okay, this is a globe. Okay, this is a globe. In the globe, you can see, when you look into the globe, you can see a middle line here, midline in the globe. Okay, this midline is known as equator. Okay, in between the globe, there is an equator. Equator. Okay, so this equator divides north and south. Okay, what does this equator do for us? So this equator divides north and south. So this part, the above part, is known as northern hemisphere. Okay, the above part is known as northern hemisphere. The below part, the part below the equator, is known as southern hemisphere. South hemisphere and the part above the equator is known as northern hemisphere. So now, where is the North American continent? The North American continent is here. It is above the equator. So that means we can understand that the North American continent is in which hemisphere? It's in the northern hemisphere. Do you understand what I said? Okay, now I have said that who discovered North America? North America is the third largest continent, and Christopher Columbus, the Italian explorer, discovered North America. And where is the North America situated? North America is situated in the northern hemisphere of the globe. Okay, I hope you understood that. Okay, so what makes the North America special? Okay, what is the special there in North America? Okay, there are two mountains are there. The highest mountain points are there. Two mountain points are there. These two mountain points makes North America special. The mountains names are there. Mount McKinley in Alaska. Okay, Mount McKinley in Alaska. And the second mountain is the rocky stretches of Appalachian. Okay, the highest point in the North America. HIGHEST, highest point in North America. Highest mountain is the Mount McKinley in Alaska. And there are two other mountains are there. The Rockies, R-O-K-I-R-O-C-K-I-E-S, Rockies, and the Appalachian Mountains, A-P-P-A-L-A-C-H-I-A-N, LACHIAN, Appalachian Mountains. Okay. So now North America is as third largest continent, and it is in the northern hemisphere. What does it make special? Mount McKinley in Alaska is the highest point in North America, and there are two more mountains are there. The two mountains are the Rockies and the Appalachian Mountain. Okay, I hope you understood about the North American continent, aren't you? Okay, let's go for the fourth one. Okay, this is the third largest, and now let's go for the fourth largest continent. Okay, which is the fourth largest continent after North America? Let's go. Let's have a look here. Which one is the largest one? Okay, North America. Then after South America. So which is next is South America. Fourth largest continent is South America. SOUTH, South, AMERICA, North America and South America. Okay, where is the South America? Okay, we have seen North America in the globe. Let's go to the globe, and you can just below that. The North America. This is the South America. As I have said that North America is in which hemisphere? It is in the North hemisphere. Now the South hemisphere. Then let's just come down to the South hemisphere. Here is the South America. Have you seen South America? Okay. Now let's take our textbook. In our textbook. Okay, if you, all of you may not have globe at your home, all of you may not, it's not possible for all of you to see the globe. So let's, here this is the North America and this is the South America below that. Okay, so in North America is, South America is the fourth largest continent. Fourth largest continent is the South America. Okay, South America, when you look into the globe, I'll show you the globe. This is the North America. This is the North America and this is the South America, isn't it? Now, it's both have a small connection. North America and the South America have a connection. Here you can, visible in your textbook. See, in between North America and South America, here is a connection, isn't it? Okay. So, here is a very narrow land here. That is known as Isthmus of Panama. Okay, so Isthmus of Panama connects North America and the South America. Okay, it's a very narrow land. This narrow land connects the North America and the South America. Look into your textbook. Okay, here it is. Okay, there is a, when you come to the textbook, here is a small narrow land, very thin and narrow land connect these two continents. Okay, so this connection is known as Isthmus of Panama. Okay, so Isthmus of Panama connects the North America and the South America. Okay, Isthmus Isthmus of Panama, PANAMA. Okay, Isthmus of Panama. When you go in, take in your textbook, it is there in a flattened map. And when you come to the globe, even you can understand that here is a small part which is connecting these two continents. Okay, here it is. This is a small part, and this small narrow land connect North America and the South America. Okay, so what is special in South America? What is special? Here is an Amazon rainforest. Okay, Amazon rainforest is the special in South America. Okay, let's see. The famous Amazon rain, R-A-I-N-F-O-R-E-S-T. REST. Amazon rainforest. It is the special in North South American continent. And this is what is the specialty of Amazon rainforest. This is the thickest forest. Thickest forest. I think you all have seen the forest. Some of you will have seen the forest, and some of you may not have seen the forest. So some of the forests are thick, some of them are not thick. So here the Amazon rainforest, the thickest forest in the world. So that is in which continent? That is in North American continent. Okay. So the specialty of the South American continent. And the South American continent, fourth largest continent, Isthmus of Panama connects the North America and South America. And here is the Amazon rainforest, which is the thickest forest in the world. Okay. Next one. I hope you understood all about the South American continent. Okay, once again I'm repeating, the South American continent is in the south hemisphere of the equator, and it is the fourth largest continent, and Isthmus of Panama in a narrow land connects North America and South America. And here is Amazon rainforest as are there, which is the thickest forest in the world. Okay, I hope you understood all about the South America. Before finishing or concluding the class, let me go for a small recap. Okay, today we have studied three continents. Those are Africa, North America, and the South America. Okay, our chapter name is our continent and the oceans. Okay, Africa. Africa is the second largest continent in the world, and the specialty of Africa is the largest river Nile flows through Africa, and the largest resort is in Africa, and the Suez Canal, which is a man-made canal, is two-way transportation connects is in Africa. And the third largest continent is North America. North America has a mount is in the northern hemisphere of the equator. It's a specialty of the North America is Mount McKinley in Alaska is the highest point in North America. There are two more mountains, that is the Rockies and Appalachian Mountain. And the fourth largest continent is the South American continent. It is the fourth largest continent. Isthmus of Panama connects the North America and South America. Isthmus of Panama is a narrow land. And Amazon rainforest, which is the thickest rainforest in the world, is in North America. This is all about today. Students, you must memorize all the points, three points of each continent. Doing your homework is to memorize all these points of point by point of every continent. So that may be easy for you to your studies. Okay, let's wind up the class today here. I hope you all will study at your home. I hope you all enjoy. Thank you for watching. God bless you.